I know that DXA invested in a company called Modern Logistics. Perhaps you could talk to me about the nature of logistics infrastructure in Brazil and what meaningful developments or transitions are taking place. How is technology being used, or how should it be used to disrupt the sector?
Yes, it's a great point. Brazil consumer trends and patterns is not very different than what we've seen in other countries around the world. So what we will see is, and I sometimes I make fun, I say it's like we have a crystal ball because we can see what happened in the US, what happened in other countries, and that's going to happen there also. But when we look in regards to the infrastructure available in order to allow a straightforward, only pure technology disruption, the infrastructure simply is not there. So when we look at cases like Alibaba in China or even Amazon in the US, both of them used the infrastructure that already existed, either through US Postal Service or through the Chinese government's infrastructure investments. And they were able to create solutions that were based on technology, but they were leveraging off an infrastructure that existed. That's not the case in Brazil. There's infrastructure in the Southeast, but in the middle of the country and in the Northeast, it's simply not connected. As I mentioned, there's less than 14% of the roads are paved. And the situation that we live today is that while when we discuss about long haul trucking in the US, we're talking roughly about 100 miles, it's long haul trucking. In Brazil, we're talking about 10,000 kilometers. So what we see is a situation of a country that's very heavily dependent on trucking. And there's more than 3 million different trucking companies that can be from mom and pop shops that have like one truck or two trucks to larger structures, larger companies that have thousands of trucks. So what we do see is that the solution in order to be able to have a true national resolution or a national solution for logistics, it needs to be private because it's going to take decades and decades for the government to be able to invest to create the roads or the waterways or the railroads needed in order for someone like a Alibaba, Amazon, or another big player. The lack of infrastructure from a public standpoint, from a government supplied standpoint, made us view that the solution needed to be private. So we met in 2014, Gerald Lee, who was the founder of Modern Logistics, and this CEO, he was originally from JetBlue, went down to Brazil to start Azul Airlines, which is a very successful passenger airline. And when he saw this same opportunity set, the same lack of infrastructure, he saw that the solution for logistics needed to be a one-stop shop firm that could offer from warehouse to trucking, but that it owned its own airline. Because if you own your own airline, you're able to structure specific solutions for a client's need that you can't do that by just using the empty space on the belly of a passenger airline plane. So what he decided to do was to create Modern Logistics in the same situation, similar to a Blue Dart in India or a YTO, or even in the US, FedEx, supply chain solutions. So the idea was that through servicing large industrial clients that are already shifting products all across the country. Logistics in Brazil, just to give you an idea, it's about 12% of the GDP, so give or take about $240 billion. So it's a very big market.
Oh, right.
So the idea was that once you start tapping with these large industrial clients to create a X for the country, then you would be able to create on top of that marketplaces and in essence cut the middleman that exists in so many different sectors because of this lack of infrastructure. And that's what happened with Modern Logistics. We invested in the company almost 4 years ago. And since then, they started to offer their products. They started flying. They started to shift products. Today, their reach is a reach that allows to be delivered to about 4,500 cities in the country. So we're talking about roughly 99% of the country that is their current reach. And they have solutions that now go around the whole country. So what we see as an opportunity set in the country is being able to offer solutions that they won't be very similar or just like what happened in the international cases, because it will be dependent on what kind of infrastructure currently exists. So yes, we do believe Amazon Prime is the future, just like as we see it in the US. But it needs to have a very strong logistics solution. And that logistics solution won't be of simply relying on what the government has made, because unfortunately the country doesn't have a public infrastructure solution. So I think that's how we see the opportunity set. There are definitely cases of last mile solutions of companies being worth billions, more than $1 billion nowadays. And we think that this is probably one of the biggest opportunities that we could ever see in this decade.
Something